We are following breaking news right now of that oil platform fire in the Gulf of Mexico. This about 80 miles south of Vermilion Bay, which you can locate here on our map. Now, the Coast Guard has confirmed that the platform exploded around 9 o'clock this morning, leaving all 13 people on board that platform in the water. As a result, we have just learned, though, all 13 people are accounted for, and we have at this time received word of one injury. Now, some people rescued from the water there are being taken to Terrebonne General Medical Center in Houma for evaluation. And by the way, that rig is owned by Mariner Energy, based out of Houston. The company, though, also has an office in Lafayette. Now, WDSU News reporter Rosa Flores is in our newsroom making calls right now. And Rosa, we do want to clarify that this explosion happened on board an oil platform, not an oil rig. Can you explain to us what that difference is?
Well, Melanie, the easiest way to explain it is a rig drills and a platform produces. Now, we have a picture for you, and we want to clarify that this is not the actual platform where this happened, but just so you can see what we're talking about. So a platform produces oil. Now, we just learned that this particular platform was not producing any oil at this point, but we just wanted to make sure we showed you what this was about, and so you can get a visual. Now, Melanie, the other thing I can tell you, back in the day when, you know, deep water drilling first started, all platforms were platforms and drills because they had, if you can remember, those little towers that we would always see. Well, now, I mean, you know, it's been a couple of decades since this type of drilling has happened. Now, drilling rigs move around in the Gulf. And so that's the easiest way to explain the difference between the rig and a platform.
Yeah, and Rosa, we're also hearing from the Department of Homeland Security that that platform you're talking about was in about 2,500 feet of water there, to put that into perspective. And I also hear that you've been talking to the head of the Louisiana Oil and Gas Association. What are you finding out there?
Well, of course, a lot of concern for the people on board the platform. And, you know, in everybody's mind is the moratorium. And so I just got off the phone with him, and he tells me that it's too early to determine exactly how this could affect the moratorium. But he says, you know, this probably will not help, just because of all of everything that we've heard. And, you know, I mean, just about a month ago, that organization had a big rally to talk about, you know, the effects of the moratorium along coastal Louisiana and how this has been impacting jobs. And it's in everybody's mind. So he says that it's too early to tell, but his gut feeling is it's not going to help.
And Rosa, I know from what we know at this point, we do not know if any oil is leaking into the Gulf of Mexico as a result of this explosion. From your phone calls and your research there in the newsroom, have you heard anything other than that?
Yeah, no, I haven't heard anything along those lines. That, of course, and on everybody's mind as well, because of what happened with the Deepwater Horizon, all the oil that we've already seen along coastal Louisiana. And, you know, I bet as people are watching this, they have their fingers crossed that no more oil, no more gas, no more nothing is spewing into the Gulf.
Right. Okay. Rosa, thanks so much for that information coming out of our newsroom there. Rosa Flores. And if you remember back when the Deepwater Horizon oil rig exploded, we were hearing the same things about no oil would be a threat in the Gulf of Mexico. And certainly that turned out not to be the case. So we are continuing to keep our fingers on the very latest information we can get. Also, a little bit more information for you. There are 7 Coast Guard helicopters responding right now, 2 airplanes and 3 cutters, all dispatched from New Orleans, Mobile, and Houston. So we're giving you the latest information on that. Now, we do know, just finding out now, that Governor Bobby Jindal will be holding a press conference about this accident in about an hour. So we'll, of course, bring that to you live here from WDSU. We also have crews making their way to these areas affected. Again, an oil platform exploded, not an oil rig, an oil platform exploded about 80 miles south of Vermilion Bay in the Gulf of Mexico. All 13 people on board that platform are accounted for. We're also continuing to keep you updated online, so you can check that source at any time at WDSU.com.